In 1976, as Walter Mannert taught a course on medical ethics, he noticed an increase in ethically important considerations on ethics cases that involved the use of computers, and was later on convinced that this phenomenon required its own branch of applied ethics, known as computer ethics. Despite the multitude of concerns relating to computer ethics, there were four main concerns: crime, failure, protection, and privacy. This was taken into consideration by the Computer Ethics Institute of Washington, D.C., and thus laid down the Ten Commandments of Computer Ethics in 1992. So what are the Ten Commandments of Computer Ethics? Number 1. Thou shalt not use a computer to harm other people. Imagine being asked to program a helping robot, but instead, you program it to kill and made other inventions alongside it to bring about mass destruction. This act violates the first commandment. Number 2. Thou shalt not interfere with other people's computer work. Let's say one of your co-workers' performance was better than yours, and due to the hatred you felt, you program a virus that destroyed all the valuable files and documents of your co-worker. Number 3. Thou shalt not snoop around in other people's files. Let's say you are working alone in the office and found yourself stuck in one of the tasks that you have been assigned with not much integrity. You proceeded to open your co-worker's computer and read every work file they had to help you finish your task. This violates the right of your co-worker as well as the third commandment. Number 4. Thou shalt not use a computer to steal. A notable real-life case happened in 2009 when Miami-based hacker Albert Gonzalez stole tens of millions of credit card and debit card numbers from over 250 financial institutions. This was considered as one of the biggest fraud cases in U.S. history, and Gonzalez pled guilty in December of the same year. Number 5. Thou shalt not use a computer to bear false witness. There has been an uprising in the creation of deepfakes recently, and it has mainly been used for cosmetic purposes. However, falling into the wrong hands and minds, this can stir up global concerns and spread falsified information, especially to those unaware of it.
I'm not Adele.
Number 6. Thou shalt not use or copy software for which you have not paid. Some people who have a deeper knowledge in software piracy and theft tend to download a cracked or pre-activated version of a paid software that they choose, and some have the guts to make a profit out of these pirated softwares. Number 7. Thou shalt not use other people's computer resources without authorization. A good scenario of violation would be finding out your coworker's email address and password. One day, you decided to access their account and pretended to be them while accessing some of their resources without their consent. Number 8. Thou shalt not appropriate other people's intellectual output. Imagine at work, you were asked to present in front of the company's board members, and you presented content, text, and images that were from the website you saw on the internet. Without proper credit and reference, this can be subject to copyright infringement, especially if the content you copied online was not free for public or commercial use. Number 9. Thou shalt think about the social consequences of the program you write. Despite years of training to write programs that help make lives easier, there are still cases wherein programs are written to disrupt balance in the society. Computer professionals are compelled to avoid writing this kind of programs in adherence to the professional code of conduct. Number 10. Thou shalt use a computer in ways that show consideration and respect. Flaming and other sorts of cyberbullying are examples of a clear violation of this commandment. Instead, what we can do is preserve a harmonious and peaceful community free from negativity and threats. The Ten Commandments of Computer Ethics is not enough to cover the wide variety of ethical concerns in the usage of computers, but despite the ambiguity, this can be used as a basic reference on how we, both professionals and non-professionals, ought to act responsibly, whether we are offline or online.